Start with focusing on this blue right-angled triangle. We can apply Pythagorean theorem on this triangle to find the length of the line segment DC as 15 units. Let's write that on the question also. Now focus on this right-angled triangle EBC. Applying Pythagorean theorem on this triangle, line segment EC can be calculated as 24 units. Let's also see that on the question. Now focus on these blue and green right-angled triangles. And notice that they are similar triangles by angle-angle rule. So we can write these similarity ratios. First, let's use the first part of this equality and write down the values we know. Simplifying this, we will have a 5 over 6 ratio for the sides AD and AE. So let's call side AD as 5k and side AE as 6k. And also let's show these values on the diagram. Now let's use the second part of the similarity equation. We know the DB over EC ratio is 5 over 6. Now instead of AB, we can write 7 plus 6k. And instead of side AC, we can write 15 plus 5k. So let's solve this equation to find the value of k. After cross multiplying and simplifying, we will have 33 equals 11k. And from here, k will be equal to 3. So since side AE is 6k units, it will be 18 units. Similarly, side AD is 5k units, so it will be 15 units. Now focus on this right-angled green triangle. And notice that point D is the midpoint of the hypotenuse of this triangle. Since the midpoint of the hypotenuse should be equidistant from the vertices of the triangle, the diameter of the circle should also be 15 units. Now let's connect point F and point D. And notice that this angle should be a 90 degree angle, since it is subtended by the diameter of the circle. Now focus on this isosceles triangle. And notice that line segment FD is the height of the isosceles triangle drawn from the apex angle. So it must divide the 18 units bottom line segment into two equal 9 unit parts. After this, let's identify two cyclic quadrilaterals in the question. The first one is EFGD, and the second one is BEDC. And now we are going to use a handy property of cyclic quadrilaterals. The opposite angles sum up to 180 degrees. Now let's start with labeling this angle as alpha. So the opposite angle will be 180 minus alpha. Therefore, this angle will also be alpha degrees. Notice that angle D of the second quadrilateral is also 180 minus alpha degrees. Therefore, the opposite angle of this quadrilateral will also be alpha degrees. Now notice that we have two congruent alpha degree angles here, which means that line segment FG and BC are parallel. After this, we are one step closer to finding our missing length AK. And to do that, let's focus on this blue triangle AFK and green triangle ABL. Since we showed earlier that the bottom lines of these two triangles are parallel, we can say that they are similar triangles by angle-angle rule. So we can write this similarity ratio of AF over AB equals AK over AL. From here, AK will be equal to AF times AL over AB. We know that AF is 9 units, and AB is 9 plus 9 plus 7, which is 25 units. But we don't know the length of the line segment AL. To find that, let's focus on the largest triangle ABC. And let's write the area of this triangle using AL as height, which is AL times BC over 2. And this time, write the area using EC as height, which is EC times AB over 2. When we insert the values we know, we can find AL as 24 units. Now let's insert AL into our equation and find AK as 9 times 24 over 25, which is 8.64 units. And that is our answer. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this. I'll see you on the next one.